There are times when you want to add a comment into a LibreOffice Writer document. It might be a note for yourself to come back to make a change later, or you may be reviewing someone else's work, and you may want to leave a comment for them. Inserting a comment is pretty easy. All we need to do is place our cursor where we want to insert our comment, then go up to Insert, Comment, and type in our message. I want to bold this U, and then for the font work, I'm going to italicize it and underline it. So we can add a few different effects here to our comment, but if I highlight something and try and change the font itself, it doesn't work. And there's really no reason to. It is just a comment. This is not where you want to have all your effects, but maybe the bold and the underline to emphasize a few things. If we look at who made the comment, it says unknown author. If I'm just making some comments to remind me of something to do later, the unknown author is fine. But if we have multiple people reviewing this document, we wouldn't be able to tell who made what comment. To change the name that shows up on the document, we would need to go into Tools, Options, LibreOffice User Data, and we're going to put in the name Jack. Now Jack's going to enter in a comment, Insert, Comment. And he comes out as a different color because it's a different user. Now let's change the user to Jenna. Jenna wants to reply to Jack's message. So I'm going to go into Tools, Options. By the way, the idea about changing the name on your computer is to do it only one time on your computer. You should not need to change it again and again. I'm just changing it here to simulate multiple users. So we're going to put in Jenna. And Jenna wants to reply to Jack's message. There's a couple ways she can do this. One is to click the arrow down and click reply. Or if we just click inside Jack's message, insert comment. And there's Jenna. And she's going to place her reply in now. And we notice that Jenna is a different color than Jack, which is different than the unknown author. So far, the comments have all been a different color and fallen right below one another. Let's go back and change the user to be Jack. And this time, I'm going to place my cursor to the left of the comments we already made. And I'm going to insert, comment, and we see we're back to blue, Jack's color. And it came on top because I've moved it to the left. So if it's to the left of the previous comment, it goes above. And to the right of the comment or replying goes below. Now I want to look at my document again without those comments, but I don't want to delete them. I just want to hide them. To do that, we go into View and turn off the comments. And it looks like they're gone. But to bring them back, we just click View again and turn them back on. I want to point out right here that this is to help teams of people who are already working together. Any person can change anyone else's comment or delete them. I'm still signed in as Jack, but Jack is going to go in and update Jenna's comment. And he can successfully do that. Maybe he wants to change this. Should be a capital F for font work. So he's helping out the unknown author. He can delete Jenna's comment or delete all. And we can also undo that delete. So these comments are not restricted by users. Any author can change or delete any other author's comments.